The lingcod is a ferocious predator that inhabits the waters of the Pacific Ocean from Alaska to California, with large and dense populations in British Columbia, Canada. Lingcod are a bottom-dwelling fish that can be found from intertidal depths all the way down to 100 meters. They prefer to inhabit rocky areas where they can hide in holes and caves while waiting for unsuspecting prey. Lingcod feed on invertebrates and many species of fish, including rockfish and salmon. The lingcod is distinguished by its elongated body with a long dorsal fin and massive head with a mouth full of sharp teeth. Brown, gray, green, reddish brown, and even bluish lingcod can be spotted. Scales cover their body except for their head. They can grow over a meter in length and can weigh over 30 kilograms. Females grow significantly larger than males. Males rarely exceed 90 centimeters in length, and females rarely 120. Males live to about 14 years of age, and females to roughly 20. Although referred to as a cod, lingcod are in the greenling family, the same group as kelp greenling, painted greenling, and the elusive rock greenling. During the fall, males begin to set up territories on rocky substrates. Spawning occurs in December through March, with the majority occurring from mid-January to mid-February. Females move into spawning areas at night to deposit their eggs, larger females up to a half a million. The eggs are deposited in crevices or under rocks and become a firm cohesive mass, which takes an appearance similar to styrofoam. The male lingcod remains with the egg mass and actively guards them from predators. Nests will not survive if a guarding male is removed. For this reason, winter closures for lingcod have been put in place to protect the guarding males. Another win for spearfishing, as there is zero bycatch. Anglers pull males off egg masses during off-season, and even if the male is released, the eggs will be unprotected and devoured shortly after. Each year, OceanWise Research runs the lingcod egg mass survey to help learn and understand about lingcod populations. As a recreational diver, I would highly encourage you to contribute your findings. I'll leave a link in the description. The rules and regulations for recreational fishing can be found on the Department of Fisheries and Oceans Canada website. As a Spiro, you are required to obtain a recreational fishing license, which can be purchased online. You'll need to check the area map and know the location you plan to fish. Spearfishing in a rockfish conservation area, marine protected area, or dive closure area, such as Ogden Point or the Discovery Passage in Campbell River, is prohibited. Lingcod populations were decimated around the lower mainland of British Columbia and are still struggling to this day. There are zero opportunities available to harvest lingcod around Vancouver. Next, check the species regulation table for fishing opportunities and basic regulations. Lingcod have to measure 65 centimeters in order to be considered legal. Lingcod mature around 45 centimeters, so it's important to let them produce some offspring before removing them from the ecosystem. Lingcod season will vary from location to location. For example, Area 19 typically runs from May 1st of each year until September 30th, but Area 22 typically from April 1st to November 15th. I say typically, as these dates are subject to change. Remember, it's your responsibility to keep an eye out for the most up-to-date information. Lingcod have to be transported with the head intact, as an officer may have to measure your catch to ensure compliance. A lingcod found in possession with a severed head will be considered undersized, and fines and penalties issued accordingly. You'll have to research your daily limit, which is the maximum number of a given fish species that you're allowed to harvest in one day. Some areas only permit one lingcod, as others allow a very generous three. Again, always confirm before heading out. The possession limit is the maximum number of fish you can have in your possession at any given time, except for what's at your ordinary residence. For example, if I went on a three-day boating trip in Area 22 with a lingcod possession limit of six, I should not have any more than six lingcod in my possession at any given time. Daily limits always need to be adhered to, but if I obtain my possession limit on the second day and had a lingcod for dinner that night, that would open up an opportunity for another lingcod on the third day. I would highly discourage you from shooting any more than one lingcod per day, regardless of what the limit may be. More on that later. Annual limits are in place around certain areas of British Columbia. The annual limit is the total amount of fish of a certain species that may be caught and retained during the course of a fishing year, which commences on April 1st and ends the following March 31st. Historically, Southern Vancouver Island and the Gulf Islands have an annual limit of 10. When a lingcod has been caught in an area with an annual limit, immediate documentation on your fishing license is required. The outside waters, such as Area 22, historically have had no applicable annual limit. Don't be intimidated by the fisheries regulations. Play around on their website, and with some practice, the regs will become second nature. Lane cod are territorial and usually stay in the same location for most of their lives, possibly even the same rock pile. Spearfishing is by far the most selective and sustainable form of fishing, but there are only so many short, accessible areas breath-hole divers can access to go around. If you and a group of friends all head to one spot and shoot your daily limit of 3 lane cod repeatedly, it will take no time at all before the reef goes bare. I've had people try and justify shooting 3 due to the time, money, and effort spent in order to get to a spot, but think of it this way. What's better, 3 lane cod today and 0 going forward, or a responsible harvest of 1 with a sustainable approach for the future? With that said, BC is a massive province. Get out there and explore our coastline and see what it has to offer. Spread your fishing pressure out to a wide variety of species and areas. A lane cod honey hole won't last long if you don't let it breathe. As noted, lane cod have to measure 65 centimeters. Sizing up a lane cod underwater can be a challenge to the untrained eye. It's a fairly common practice to mark 65 centimeters on your spear gun and use that as a reference before shooting. I'd recommend taking that one step further and mark 70 centimeters on your gun and give yourself a solid buffer. Lane cod are fairly brave and put a lot of faith in their camouflage, which allows us to take our time and get nice and close for a clean shot. At the end of the day, err on the side of caution, and when in doubt, don't take it out. Anglers try to use the measuring argument to outlaw spearfishing, but informed decisions can be made before pulling the trigger. Same can't be said while dropping a hook and line to depth while indiscriminately catching anything that bites, rockfish and guarding males included. Egg masses take anywhere from 8 to 10 weeks to hatch, which usually takes place early March through late April. Lane cod retention opportunities in the outside waters typically begin April 1st. If you're harvesting during this period and come across a male still guarding eggs, don't be that person. That one lane cod is not worth taking out a potential 500,000 eggs. Be responsible, let the fish do its thing, and ensure the reef stays populated. And with that said, lane cod have a minimum size retention, but no maximum. The larger the female, the larger the egg mass they are capable of depositing. Both males and females play an important role in reproduction, but it's best to let the massive female breeders go. I've shot some pretty hefty ling in the past, but I don't bypass a smaller legal size one in order to do so. Trust me, it's easier said than done, but once a ling cod surpasses 30 pounds, the quality of meat will deteriorate anyway. Make your own decision, but at least you have some food for thought. On a final note, ling cod are one of my favorite fish, if not my favorite. In fact, I did a grade 5 school project on ling cod in the year 2000. Some things never change. They are not only delicious, but are also mean, rugged, and a ferocious predator. They are the epitome of the Pacific Northwest and are a prized fish in the spearfishing community. Spearfishing has been growing in popularity around British Columbia, and the resulting pressure on the reefs have as well. We are all in this together, so let's work towards a common goal and ensure the regulations and best practices are followed. I'd love there to be an opportunity for my son and daughter to spear ling cod too. Thanks for watching, everyone. Feel free to ask any questions you may have or throw down your 2 cents in the comments. And as always, peace and love.